Let's go. Okay, guys, welcome to the first replay roast uploaded to YouTube. I'm your host, Buzz Killington, and let's get this underway. Thanks to Tom Eric for sponsoring this. And the first game that we are uploading features Paflagon 2, or possibly Paflagon 2, however you want to say it, of the mighty wolf pack, or the werewolf pack as we're known at the moment, and Bulldog, another pack member who has joined Brazil Elite for some reason. But hey, there's no accounting for taste, and we value him as well, though obviously not as much as Paf 2 right now. Let's take a look at the decks before we get this underway. Paf 2 is running APC Strongarm with Orca Classic deck. Bulldog is running Marauder Chem Buggy, just to bring some rage to Tom Eric. He's got Chuggy there. He does have Stealth Tank as well. Bulldog starts with the Scout, gets that early game advantage. He knows he's up against it with Paf 2, and he is a... There's a little bit of moisture in his trousers right now. He's facing the mighty Paf 2. Look at the way Paf 2 dances those troops, even though there's absolutely no possible earthly reason to even need to do so. That is because he's got so much skill in his fingers. He cannot help but deal with that. Either that or he... I wouldn't like to speculate. But he's got mighty skill. Bulldog builds a second scout squad in a craven attempt to forestall the inevitable. And he opts to go bikes. Because he's just like, logically, when you're facing infantry, what you want to do is build bikes. That seems like a very sensible thing to do. He's going to try and go Chem Buggy in a second to deal with this infantry. There you go. But the Orca is coming out from Paf 2. Perhaps in anticipation of this, he's gonna try and take the Chem Buggy down. Is he going to succeed? Nah, the Chem Buggy's just going to make a run for it. Instead, he could take out the bikes and snatch that missile. Look at that flip. Look at that flip. He made it look easy, and Bulldog's much vaunted Chem Buggy accomplished absolutely nothing. Turret drop, not really sure why. Maybe Paf got a bit excited, those twitchy fingers again, guys. And that Chem Buggy is now sitting there thinking, just what am I going to do? It gets close. It does actually justify some of its pay by taking out a 10-cost unit. That's money well spent. Bulldog is an angry, angry young puppy right now, and he's just going to leave his laser troops to die. Oh, he's noticed that now, eventually. He's eventually noticed that he's leaving his troops to die. So that's great on him. And look at Bulldog now. He's pushing forward. He's got an advantage. He knows the Orca's coming. It gets a nice round of hits from the bike. And the Stealth Tank doesn't finish it off. The Stealth Tank does not finish it off. And instead he opts to land a single shot on the Talon instead of holding it off for the Orca, which he could have used to kill it. But why would he do that when he can just throw the Stealth Tank away? I mean, after all, they are really cheap. Oh, wait, no, they're not. But he does manage to get a missile by sacrificing that Chem Buggy in a very heroic fashion. Finally, the Orca goes down, but it's all right because he's just going to build another one pretty much straight away. What's the Stealth Tank going to do? It's going to dance around there. He doesn't want to waste his shots this time. Paf 2 forces the reveal, and Bulldog on the back foot is going to build a laser wall. But Paf 2, unafraid of this, and having gone double harvester in a point that was completely unnoticed by your caster, which really bodes well for my skills, has built two harvesters. So he's going to churn out a lot of APCs. The Marauders walk in, take about a third damage. Marauders are tanky boys, though, so not too worried about that. Oh, the switch. Nice micro, credit where it's due. Although we are against Bulldog for this round, he did do some good micro with his Stealth Tank there. The APC pushes forward. The APC's natural enemy is the gun-toting mutant, so he's really up against it right now. But the missile is continuing to charge. Who knows how this is going to go? Well, I know how this is going to go. We all know how it's going to go because Tom Eric sponsored a game that Bulldog would lose. There is a lot of choice, but this is the one it's going to be. But Bulldog looks like he's in a strong position now until, of course, he opts to throw it like this. That's actually truly impressive. Is he going to be able to turn this around? He's not. The stall, it's stalled out still. And the Stealth Tank goes down. He could move Marauders across, but he opts to do it too late. And there you go. That's the loss. The Harvester pull could have happened, but Paf 2 didn't even need it. Paf 2 did not even need it. I hope you guys enjoyed that first roast of a Rivals Roast uploaded onto my YouTube channel. Thanks very much for watching, guys. Feel free to follow me on Twitch, link below in the description, and subscribe to me on YouTube if you aren't already, because that just encourages me to produce more beautiful, rubbish content like this. Thanks for watching, guys.